watching the anger between police and the communities they patrol bubble over in places like Ferguson, Missouri, has many asking, how did it come to this? To get to the bottom of one common theory, you've got to go back to the Cold War of the 1980s. The Iran-Contra scandal was brewing and would eventually enrage the American public. The United States government had funneled $18 million from a secret $30 million arms deal with Iran into the Nicaraguan Contra-Revolutionary Group in an attempt to depose the socialist Sandinista government. The ensuing investigation unveiled something else unexpected.
Many, many, many documents were released from the Iran-Contra era that showed that the CIA was deeply involved in drug smuggling all over the United States and throughout Central and South America. I was being groomed to be in a position where I could say yay or nay to search warrants. And that's when it became clear to me that the Central Intelligence Agency was actively protecting certain large drug shipments, and that's when I drew the line and I said I wouldn't compromise my honor.
Ricky Ross, known as Freeway Ricky Ross, from South Central Los Angeles, imported Nicaraguan crack cocaine in the 80s to a drug-hungry public, pushing U.S. dollars to the cash-hungry Contras. As cocaine dealing and use spread through the American black community, drugs got cheaper and guns used to protect the loot got bigger. President Reagan's war on drugs saw heavy sentencing soar.
So once you look at this here, then it's easy for you to see that they didn't mind sacrificing a particular sector of America.
On the back of this, policing has transformed.
I think one of the things that's been really critical is that law enforcement, because of the drug war, because it's not really a war on drugs, it's a war on people, and because of the overemphasis on military-style tactics, is it creates incidents where we no longer work in collaboration with our constituents. We're no longer peace officers, which is what, you know, our statutory authority is when we're hired to be police officers. We actually just mindlessly police people. And Ferguson is part of pushing back against that mindlessly policing people.
It's what she calls mission creep, brought on by the war on drugs, then the war on terror. Now local police inherit used military equipment like tanks. Law enforcement lobbies can financially back political candidates who condone heavy tactics. And what do you get? A widely expanded power base used against a certain sector of the population. Freeway Ricky Ross served 20 years for his role in selling drugs and is now a public spokesman against drug use and how we've dealt with it as a nation.
We should have clarification on exactly what we're trying to accomplish. You can't incarcerate your way out of drug use.
California voters appear to agree. In November 2014, they voted to defelonize drug offenses. It's the first state in the nation to do so. But it's just the tip of the iceberg in fighting a new war, one between police and the people. And this story is just one theory in how it all began. In Los Angeles, Lindsay France, RT.
We are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forgive. We do not forget. Expect us.